Meiningscout ist auch heuer wieder auf der Edelmetallmesse in München und wir sind auf der Suche nach interessanten Stories. Bei dieser Gelegenheit haben wir die Gelegenheit, mit Barkerville Gold Mines zu sprechen und ich darf begrüßen neben mir Frank Callahan. Frank, thank you for trusting us and giving us the time to talk with our visitors about your company and about your function. Please, can you tell us a little bit about your company and what you are doing?
Certainly. Barkerville Gold Mines has been exploring for gold in central British Columbia for the last 20 years. We've now defined a resource of an inferred and indicated resource of just under 5 million ounces, and we're currently trying to expand that resource and expect to do so in 2014. In addition, we're actually started gold production. We've done a small test of 20,000 ounces that we did in 2011, and we expect to actually be in full production in 2014.
Thank you, that's very interesting. And let's come to a very important question for the shareholders, because what's the development of the company since their trading card situation is since 2012?
Sure. So the most important thing that was learned is that the understanding of the model is different than it was initially. Now, as opposed to being a high-grade underground mine, it's now being focused as more of a higher-grade open pit mine. And it's estimated the current resource estimate that we're looking at surpasses some of the larger mines in Canada, the Detour and Osisko models. And we expect to go forward and develop those more.
The next one is you recently announced a $15 million deal with new financing. Can you tell us a little bit more about what you are?
Sure. Eric Sprott has been a supporter of the company and a shareholder of the company since 2004, when he first financed our bulk sample that we did on Bonanza Ledge. Now he's just put $15 million into the company, which has helped the company to go forward. We're using that money to pay off some of the liabilities and to actually carry on into production in 2013, the rest of the year, and 2014.
Okay. Barker will become a short-term producer. Can you tell us the time frame till everything is fixed and ready for production?
Certainly.
From your side?
Sure. We're expecting to actually have some gold production in December of 2013. We're hoping to have it up and started. We started the construction process in the month of November, and we're carrying on with that, and then we expect to be in full production in 2014, both from Bonanza Ledge and the balance of the deposit at the QR mine.
Thank you. That's a short time. And what are you expecting on the all-in costs for this production?
We expect the all-in cost to be in the $900 an ounce range. We're hoping to improve that, but right now is the resource estimate is shown in our compliant technical report that we're about $900 an ounce.
Oh, that looks impressive, because 900 is it's very deep. So you are in a good position for maybe a declining gold price also.
For sure, but at the same time, unlike some of our other fellows that are in the industry, is that we have a lower overhead. We have very good access to the property. The infrastructure, you know, there's paved highways, hydroelectricity and water all the way to the property, which are the most important elements.
Yeah.
And we're working in Canadian dollars, so that helps an awful lot as well.
Yeah. So, and what are the next steps in the next 12 or 6 months? What the goals are for the company?
Well, the goals are, is we have so many assays that have to be re-assayed because the model is now different. And we are going through, we have some 27,000 assays at the lab now, and expect to have more going into 2014. So without having to drill any more holes, there's going to be more information coming from the existing data that we have that's going to be redone. So in the first quarter of 2014, we're expecting to have a new resource estimate, hopefully higher, of course. And I think that's going to make all of the shareholders of Barkerville very, very happy.
So it becomes a much more interesting month in the next half year into the company with the progress and the start of the production line. It would be very nice to see it in real.
Oh yes, well, we encourage all of the German people, whoever the audience is that looks at this, if they make it to Vancouver, we take them up to the property and we show them how we pour gold. You know, this area is the reason that British Columbia joined Confederation, and the placer gold that's gone on in this area, it's fabulous for everybody to see, and we really encourage the people to come up and see the property, and we give tours daily.
Maybe we could see us again from the site visit.
Yes.
So we can show our visitors and our readers what's going on the property directly and the re-election.
Well,
so shortly for to be a producer.
Well, for those listeners of yours, you know, there's the Cambridge House in January of this year. It's a wonderful time to actually come to British Columbia. There's lots of snow on the ground, but we can ski at Whistler and Blackcomb, and at the same time, we can go for a visit up to the mine. It's very good.
Oh, thanks, Frank. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for coming. Bye-bye.